Welcome to Hood War Stories. In this episode, I'll be discussing the Pacoima Piru Bloods. Pacoima Piru, also known as 2Ps, are a primarily Black American gang located on the east side of Pacoima in the San Fernando Valley of LA County. They have been active since the 1980s and are one of the most reputable Black gangs in the valley. Their territory runs along Glen Oaks Boulevard, between Van Nuys Boulevard and Osborne Street. Their area is surrounded by rival Latino gangs. The Pierce Park Apartments, also known as Vietnam Apartments, is considered their main headquarters. They are allies with the Legion Street Gangsta Bloods, who are located in Panorama City. They beef it with the Wayside Crips, Barrio San Fernando, Land Times, and Village Boys. On February 10th, 2002, Marcario, who was a member of the Wayside Avenue Crips, was attending a house party in the area claimed by Pacoima Piru. Sudanese Sang, who was a young woman who was also at the party that night, Lee Zell Jr. and Jamar Price, who were from Pacoima Piru, came to the house party to pick up Sudanese. When the car pulled up, Marcario and Sudanese both walked up to the car. Lee and Marcario, who had both attended the same high school, briefly conversed calmly. Sudanese heard Lee saying something about Marcario not remembering him, and Marcario responded with, I know, dude. Marcario then walked away. Sudanese then noticed Lee had a gun on his lap and asked, what the hell you bring that for? Sudanese then talked to Lee about picking up her friend and going to a club. She went back into the house to grab her shoes and call her friend. She came back outside 10 minutes later. Marcario's car, which had been parked in front of Jamar's car, was gone. Lee then told Sudanese that he had some business he had to go take care of and would talk to her later. He and Jamar then drove off. A short time later, some of the guests were leaving the party. As they were driving away, they saw Marcario's car crashing into a nearby fence. There were several bullet holes in the car, and the driver's side window was shattered. Marcario had been shot in the head and in the back of his shoulder. He died from multiple gunshot wounds. The gun used to shoot Marcario was found in a bush behind Jamar's home. Lee Zell Jr., from Pacoima Piru, was ultimately convicted of first-degree murder. On June 30, 2003, around 10 p.m., Stephen Uhas, who was from the Sanford Gang, was at the Semar Park Gymnasium located on Borden Avenue. When he got into a dispute with three Pacoima Piru members, a gun was pulled, and Stephen ultimately died from a gunshot wound to the torso. Stephen's death was followed up by several crimes against Black Americans, most of whom were non-affiliates, and the Sanford Gang saw revenge on any Black American within their community, whether they are affiliated or not. On the evening of July 27, 2003, Rashid Coleman went to a birthday party for Teresa and two of her cousins. The party occurred on the 13500 block of Sarah Street in Selmar. As the party was ending and people began walking out of the house, a few Sanford gang members were harassing some females outside of the party. Rashid's friend, Michael Rosales, approached the females and put his arm around them and pretended to be their brother while escorting them back to the house. An altercation then broke out between the Sanford gang members and a few of the partygoers. A Sanford gang member then approached Rashid, who was quietly standing nearby, and shot him with a handgun several times. Rashid died from multiple gunshot wounds, and the LAPD officer detailed that he was the only Black American in that party group. Gilbert Felix, from the Sanford gang, was ultimately convicted of first-degree murder. On October 17, 2005, Ricardo, who was from Pacoima Piru, was arriving home and was parking his car on the 12300 block of Osmer Street when a Hispanic male walked up to him and fired at him 9 times. No one was ever arrested for that crime. 2 years later, on December 7, 2007, Ricardo was driving his mom's car on his way to pick up fellow gang member DeMario. They intended to visit Terrence, who was also from Pacoima Piru, who was recovering from a gunshot wound at his home on the 12300 block of Osmer Street. At around 4:30 p.m., they arrived and parked on Osborne Place. Jose, who had lived in an apartment building across the street from Terrence's building, was on his way to a taco truck parked in front of Terrence's building. Before Jose can cross the street, DeMario yelled out, Pacoima Piru Blood, and threw up gang signs. He then pulled a gun outside his waistband and started shooting at Jose. After the first 2 shots, Jose ducked behind his auntie's SUV, who was parked nearby. As Jose yelled to DeMario to stop shooting, he could hear Ricardo urging him to keep going. While Jose was crouching next to the car, He heard 5 more shots. After the 7th shot, Jose's aunt came out to the middle of the street. As his aunt was helping him up, Jose saw DeMario, who was still holding the gun, had jumped off the retaining wall and crossed the street and was now standing about 7 feet away from him. A woman then got out of her parked car and screamed at DeMario to stop shooting because she had a baby in the car. DeMario then turned around and walked away into the main gate of Terrence's building. Jose and his family did not stay in their apartment that night or ever again. About a week after the shooting, they moved away from Pacoima. An eyewitness testified that she saw Jose curled up in a ball behind a car while Ricardo was yelling, "Smoke him, smoke him." The shooting generated multiple calls to 911, most describing a black male in a red puffy ski jacket. Police arrived to the scene and found a black backpack nearby that contained 4 semi-automatic handguns. DeMario from Pacoima, Piru was ultimately convicted of premeditated attempted murder. In September 2009, Timothy Jenkins, who was from Pacoima, Piru, and a few members of his family went to a house party. Some of the people at the house party were from a rival Crip gang. During the party, a verbal altercation occurred inside the house. Timothy and a few other people were allegedly acting out. A resident of the house told Timothy that she didn't want no trouble out of him. Timothy and his people left the house party. One of them yelled, "Blood, it ain't over." They entered a car, which crept up to the house where the party was occurring. Someone inside the car said, "Would you say blood?" A hand then came out of the open window and fired 4 shots. When the shots were fired, people were standing outside the porch area of the house. 2 people were struck by bullets. 2 bullets penetrated the garage door. The garage was used as a bedroom. At the time of the shooting, a 3-year-old girl was inside of the garage. Timothy Jenkins, from Pacoima, Piru, was ultimately convicted on 4 counts of attempted manslaughter. On July 20, 2014, Juan, who was from Humphrey Boys gang, was inside his back house while his baby mom and her mother was outside by the garage. At around 6:30 p.m., a brown car driven by a woman with red hair with at least 2 male occupants passed by. Bullets then started firing from the brown vehicle. Juan began to immediately chase down the brown car in his SUV, and police saw the brown car blow a red light while Juan's car stopped. Juan had told officers that shots had been fired at his house from the vehicle that he was pursuing. Juan's house was located in Humphrey Boys territory and was known for gang activity. Bullet holes were found in his SUV, in an RV parked in front of his house, in the garage door, and in the couch behind the door. Devontae Session, William Jones, and Anisha Johnson, who were all from Pacoima, Piru, were convicted to 3 counts of attempted murder. Around midnight on September 9, 2016, Francesco and 2 other people were drinking beer outside of an apartment complex. At some point, a few members of the Pacoima, Piru walked past Francesco and asked him what he was looking at. A physical altercation then broke out between the two, and a member of the two-piece pulled out a gun and fired 2 rounds, striking Francesco once in the jaw and once in the neck. He ended up surviving. Daniel Burney, from 2-Piece, was ultimately convicted of assault with a semi-automatic firearm. On January 11, 2021, Giovanni Ramirez was in the courtyard in the Pierce Park Apartments. At around 6 p.m., 2 Pacoima Piru members walked up and started shooting. Giovanni was struck multiple times and died at the scene. 2 Pacoima Piru members fled to a nearby Food for Less, where they were eventually apprehended. Walker Smith and Jaree Richardson were both taken into custody, and their bail was set to $2 million each. I'd like to thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.